You can change levels by going down, by coming up on your toes, or by actually leaving the ground. So next we're going to talk about directions. So in hooping, we tend to think of directions as two directions, forward and backwards. The hoops are 360 degrees, so we can do a direction that goes that way, a direction that goes this 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 way. So 360 degrees around a point that is right here in the center. So we can switch directions and make things interesting. So space and energy are two other variables that make things interesting. So you can think about space as using the space. So I can spin forward towards you. Or I can work this space from side to side. Or if I want to think about dealing with all around me, and also direction, but also as theater around, I can either stand in one place and work all the space from here, or I can actually go out and travel that circle and come back to where I started. When it comes to working a stage, two of the most interesting places to travel are catty-cornered across the stage. It's a zigzag. So this is interesting. And this is interesting. So next we have energy. So energy can be, it's like yin and yang. So this same cat eye, if I'm doing it with yin energy, it's going to look like this. But if I'm doing this cat eye with yang energy, it's going to look like this.
Dance moves. So we have lots of dance moves. We can dance with our
our hands, with our arms, or with our fingers, or with all three. We can dance with our feet, by standing still, by turning, or by traveling. We can, or by kicking, woo. Letting our feet leave the air, leave the ground. We can, and also jump through.
Y'all taking the time to play with me. It's nice to have people to talk to who are into the same things that I'm into. Mwah.